What's up everybody, Zulus here, and today I'm going to be taking a look at the Rocker gaming chair, the Nemesis, that I have, and I'm going to show you how you can hook it up to a PlayStation or an Xbox using a splitter if you can't hook it up using Bluetooth, which unfortunately some TVs do and some TVs don't support it. My Samsung in the other room works fine, and this TCL will not work. So. Yep, this is one way around it, and we'll get it rumbling and playing through it. The speakers work, and you can even play movies on it. So yeah, let's jump into this video. So first off, out of the back of your PS5 or PS4 or whatever you're using, you have HDMI. So you'd want to get a splitter like this, and this is the one I'm using right here. And this will be able to split out into RCA, which we can plug into the Nemesis chair as a pass-through, and this one also works in 4K too, which is nice because, you know, it doesn't lose anything. So so then the cord goes all the way over here, and there we go. So looking at the chair itself, we're plugged into the inputs. It is on auxiliary, not on Bluetooth, because Bluetooth doesn't work. And obviously it's plugged in, you've got the power on, and you've got your bass and your vibration all the way up. The vibration is this button right here. This is the volume button, and I'll get into that too. The volume button needs to be up a fair amount for the vibration to work. So you do have to have this up pretty loud. You can also plug in a headset, and this will still vibrate, and it'll come through here instead of the speakers on the chair. So that's kind of nice, and let me show that to you right now. So the chair is really, really loud when you crank it all the way up and get the vibration kind of functioning. So it is kind of good or nice, shall I say, if you use a headset. So let's go ahead and plug in a headset. So you can see right here when you use the gas. There it goes. So yeah, it's pretty cool. And it does vibrate well. And it also works for movies and everything else. So go ahead and show you that too. So when you play YouTube or anything that has sound, it'll make the chair vibrate. So you can play a movie, whatever you want, as long as it's going through the HDMI, obviously, that the player is going through. So in this case, it's the PS5. So you can hear it right there. That's the train horn. When it honks, it makes the chair vibrate, which is very cool. So yeah, it'll work in movies, whatever you want. I'm just using this because I didn't want to get a copyright violation, so I was using stuff on my channel. But whatever you play, if it's got music, it'll play. I guess this doesn't have any music, but if it does have music from the start, then you'll get something vibrating, which is really cool. So it totally works. And yeah, there's the chair right there, the Nemesis, when I did this video. So the chair works excellent in conjunction with the new PS5 controller, because you know, you've got the trigger sensitivity, and then you've got the vibration from this. So with improved vibration from that, and then from the chair, when you're playing games that actually have the sensitivity built in, like Dirt 5 for instance, it's really cool. It's like you have a D-box seating or something. It's awesome. You can really feel it too. It's great, you know. So I would highly recommend getting the splitter set up. The one thing it doesn't work with though is it doesn't work with party chat. So there's no real way you can do it. It'll come through your controller, but your friends will hear the buzzing and stuff and kind of give you crap. So it's great for like a one player game, watching a movie, but probably like the D-back type vibration in the back of the seat's not gonna be great for party chat. I mean, you can hear it right now. So you can imagine, But it's really cool. Like I said, yeah, it's pretty cheap, like maybe $20 to get the splitter, so it's well worth getting this thing to work right and getting the vibration to work in the seat.
So just a quick review of this video. The XRocker chair, which is this chair, does not work with a lot of TVs that do not have Bluetooth. So this way you can use the RCA inputs through a splitter like so. Plug your HDMI through the pass-through, then the HDMI to the TV using whatever you want, DVD player, PlayStation, anything you have, and it will work and vibrate with the XRocker chair. All right, everyone, thanks for checking out this video. If you have any comments, you can leave them in the description. I'll try to get back to you. And like always, peace out. Exulus.